It says Phillips filed for custody of the children back in 2008. It says Phillips was stalking his wife and children, and that she was afraid for the safety of the kids.
The sergeant's report in the paper this morning made it sound like Marsh was psychotic. Murder-suicide, case closed.
He killed his dog, killed his two kids, then he killed himself. What more do you want?
Welcome. Welcome to Fake News, the program that gives you two stories, one real and one fake, and asks you, the audience, to decide which is which.
It was friends of Michaela and Alex who called the Calaveras County Sheriff's Office saying they hadn't seen the two since Thursday. Deputies discovered them dead in their home in Murphy's, shot by their father while they were sleeping. Their father, Philip, then turned the gun on the family dog and finally himself, say deputies.
Didn't even keep his gun loaded and said he was being followed because of his book, The Big Bamboozle, Philip Marshall, about Saudi Arabian intelligence tied into the U.S. government carrying out 9/11.
Murder, suicide, or assassination? That's what you'll be asked to decide at the end of today's program. But first, a little background.
On the cockpit floor, the two pilots were dead or near dead, bled out from savage wounds to their throats. Then again, with the skill of a pilot with thousands of hours at the control, Hangzhou descends to 2,500 feet through an absolute perfect 330-degree right turn. You know, I have 15,000 hours in heavy jets, and even in a peaceful setting, I would find it hard to match that performance.
The last time I saw Phil alive was 3 weeks before he died. After his reading, I tried to give him some friendly advice.
Thank you, sweetie.
Don't think you're attracting too much attention with these cockpit stories?
I want to attract attention.
No, you're doing a good job, because I'm hearing some rumblings.
Oh.
You're starting to piss some people off.
Good.
You know, they got this thing called the Patriot Act. That's meant to deal with people like you.
There was an article about you in the international paper today. No, actually, yesterday.
About me?
About your book reading.
What did it say?
Well, they said you were a hero.
They said you were one of the only Americans willing to stand up and tell the truth.
No kidding.
Yeah, yeah. For Al-Qaeda. Doesn't any of this worry you, Marsh?
Of course it does, but it doesn't mean I'm going to sit there and bury my head in the sand.
I should never have let you send me here.
Focus on business. Everything else is a distraction.
You're sure the kids are going to be all right?
You spoke to Chris. Megan, your mom wants to talk to you.
Yeah.
What are you having for dinner?
Pasta. No, not penne, spaghetti.
Uh-oh, that sounds good. You're sure everything's going okay?
Everything's fine.
Was everything fine? According to local sources, at that hour, there were two federal agents on their way to Murphy's, where Phillips lived.
3-154, code black sensitive. Target Phillips Marshall, 1259 Scandalwood Drive, Murphy's, California. Status temporary surveillance only, pending further instructions.
That same morning, Phillips received priority mail from an old CIA friend stationed at the Pinal Airfield in Manara, Arizona.
Small town.
Everybody knows everybody. We're gonna stand out.
Yeah, I know you've heard this before, but if you need to take these for back pain, no alcohol. All right. Mixing them with alcohol can be very dangerous.
You're right, Doc. I have heard that before. Thanks a lot.
Hey, you got first.
Give me the car.
Is that him behind us?
Son of a bitch.
I'm gonna pull over.
Can I help you?
Federal agents.
Federal agents, huh?
Can we speak inside?
No, we can't.
Sir, we're aware that you're one of us.
I haven't worked for Uncle for 25 years.
He used to be a pilot for Bobby Seale. He saw a lot of shit go down.
I wrote a book about it.
Can we speak inside?
No, we can't.
Not a lot of furniture for such a nice house.
Nice picture.
Yeah, Pinal Air Park, what about it?
Your last two books.
We read them.
You received the package in the last day or two?
Contained a photograph, a highly classified photograph.
Thought you'd like to hand it over.
This conversation's over with.
You sure you won't reconsider?
Sorry for the wasted trip, please, but get the fuck off my property now. Don't you guys have some homework to do?
The neighbors all say he was great and super nice and didn't even keep his gun loaded and said he was being followed because of his book, The Big Bamboozle, Philip Marshall, about Saudi Arabian intelligence tied into the U.S. government carrying out 9/11.
Listen, the guys were just snooping around. The kids are in no danger.
Why do I ever listen to you? What the hell am I doing here?
You're there because you need to become independent, and you're there because I'm in support of that.
Where are Chris and Megan right now?
They're on Facebook. This is what I'm talking. You are an unfit father.
Well, I'm the only one they've got.
Well, I don't like the idea of federal agents snooping around our home.
Well, I told them to fuck off. Wonderful.
I swear, if anything happens...
Relax. Listen, you're going to be here in a few days. The kids are going to be with you, and you're going to be ready to get on with your new life.
What happened to the pilot that I married?
He was put out to pasture a long time ago. Don't worry, please.
So who are those guys at the door?
Do you remember a guy by the name of Madison Freeman?
Yeah, you talk about him all the time. Megan thinks he's kind of a whack job.
A whack job? Is that a joke?
That's what Mom calls him, too.
What does Mom call me?
She kind of thinks you're head whack job.
Does anybody understand what happened since a couple of years ago before you guys were born?
Yeah, but no one can understand why you're not locked up somewhere.
Do you know what I did way back in the day?
Everybody knows.
Oh, what?
You were a contract pilot for the CIA.
How do you know that?
I read your book.
So then you know what happened to Barry Seale.
Yeah, they had him killed.
Barry Seale
was going to tell something to the world that would have embarrassed some very important people. So what does that tell you?
You're next?
No, that they're hiding something, very important, right?
Like what?
Like they're not telling the truth, like always. And they keep getting away with it.
So
what does that tell you?
They made it all up so no one would find out.
So you are my son.
That's just gross.
That's the bad girl, right? She just had sex with one of the boys.
Dad?
It's the bad girl that always gets killed first.
He's right. Careful, Megan.
Philip's neighbor reported that after the two agents left, Marshall had asked him to keep an eye on the house. It wasn't until the following afternoon that anyone learned a terrible tragedy had occurred completely unobserved.
Hey, Chris! Open up! Chris!
What's up?
Chris and Megan weren't at school today. He's not answering his phone.
Did you try the bell?
Yeah.
You gotta get down here right away, 1259 Sandalwood Drive. My neighbor is lying in a pool of blood in the hallway. He's been shot in the head.
Oh my God, this doesn't happen. This just doesn't happen here. You called 911?
Over an hour ago. This is the third time I called. Look. My neighbor is lying in a pool of blood near his front door.
What'd they say?
To be patient and stay away from the house.
Isn't that odd?
Oddness doesn't begin to describe it.
Oh, Jesus!
What?
Oh, shit, I can't stand it. Call again.
Just call.
Call and tell them that there's someone in the house.
I'm going over there.
You would end up like Forrest Marshall. You stay right here. Call.
Well, things had turned decidedly odd. Someone had been in the house. It wasn't the police. It wasn't the killer. No one knew who it was. Well, how could they? The police didn't arrive for another 15 hours in the middle of the following afternoon.
Check the back. It's been 18 hours since my first call. There were people in the house last night, people with flashlights. We were terrified.
Everything's under control now, Mr.
Green. Woody Green. We live right across the street.
Okay, thank you. I'll need to get a statement from you later.
Marsh is lying right by the front door in a pool of blood.
Sir, the back door downstairs is unlocked. No signs of forced entry.
Sergeant, need to take a look at this. Two kids in there, family room.
Shot the pooch back in one of the bedrooms.
Much spirit in the faces of 14-year-old Michaela Marshall and her 16-year-old brother Alex. The two students from Bret Hart High in Angels Camp leave a whole community in mourning. It was friends of Michaela and Alex who called the Calaveras County Sheriff's Office saying they hadn't seen the two since Thursday. deputies discovered them dead in their home in Murphy's, shot by their father while they were sleeping. Their father, Philip, then turned the gun on the family dog and finally himself, say deputies.
All right,
sir. Roger that.
Yeah.
All right.
Marsh was worried. He asked me to watch the place. He asked me the afternoon before it happened.
Mr. Green, I'm going to have to come back and ask you questions later. Right now, we've got our hands full.
News of the story didn't reach me until hours later. And while I was in the air from New York, events continued to unfold at a furious pace. Events that would make Phil's story one of the greatest fake news stories of all time.
Hello, this is Sergeant DeWitt.
Sergeant DeWitt? Sharon Phillips. A man answered the phone at my husband's house and said to call you. Why are there strangers in our home?
Look at all the antennas on that one.
He really pissed someone off.
Who needs all those antennas?
Nothing to see here, folks. Go on home.
Who are you?
I said go on home. This is a crime scene.
Aren't you going to ask who he is?
I know who he is.
Who?
A guy in a dark suit in a big SUV with a dozen antennas on top.
Tonight.
It says Phillips filed for custody of the children back in 2008. It says Phillips was stalking his wife and children, and that she was afraid for the safety of the kids. It says Phillips was mentally unstable and heavily medicated when he threatened his wife's life. There was an emergency protection order issued.
Who knew we had a monster like that in this town?
He left threatening messages.
He always seemed so nice, too, you know?
Yeah, he was.
You knew him?
The girl phoned Phillips's friends.
He's my best friend.
Telling them that she was afraid of her...
I arrived at Phil's house very skeptical of what the police were saying, in this case, the Calaveras County Sheriff. No matter how I look at it, there is no way that my friend Philip Marshall killed his two kids. His 17-year-old son, his 14-year-old daughter, himself, and his little pet Shih Tzu dog.
Hey! Hey! What the hell's going on here?
Cleaning.
I can see that. The question is, why?
Murder-suicide. County hired us.
The county hire you guys?
That's what I said.
Are you? Madison, friend of Marshall's. I thought you lived in New York.
I flew out last night.
This scene is strange to you, as it does to me.
This? Strange? Well, first, second day after. Probably illegal.
Sergeant's report in the paper this morning made it sound like Marsh was psychotic. Murder-suicide, case closed.
Yeah, but you think there's more to it?
Don't you?
That's why I'm here.
I discovered the body on Friday afternoon. Nobody showed up for 18 hours. Today it's all cleaned up. Case closed.
Marsh killed both his kids, the family dog, then himself.
You don't buy that?
I talked to him on Thursday afternoon, the day it happened. He told me two agents had taken a visit. Seemed pretty worried about it. You?
Well, Marsh and I, well, yeah. We go way back. We did a lot of work together in the Dark Ages.
Oh, Dark Ages. Yeah. Woody Green. Glad to meet you. Did you read the sergeant's report?
Down at the cafe, they were reading it out loud.
Did you read the part about how Marsh died from a single gunshot wound to the right side of the head? Marsh died of a gunshot wound to the left temple, not the right.
And Marsh is right hand.
I know. You ask me, that changes everything.
I'd like to see Sergeant DeWitt.
You a reporter?
Matter of fact, I am.
The report on the Phillips murder-suicide was in today's paper.
Yeah, I read that. That's why I'm here.
Sergeant DeWitt isn't talking to the press.
Think he talked to the Department of Justice?
I'm Sergeant DeWitt.
Madison Freeman. I'm investigating the murder of Marshall Phillips.
Well, you can put that away.
You afraid to talk on the record?
Absolutely not. Phillips committed suicide.
I was with him in New York about a week ago, and I spoke with him on the phone last Thursday. And he didn't in any way seem suicidal to me.
Hmm. You came all the way from New York to tell me that.
Marsh was very concerned about the fact that he was starting to piss off some very important people.
He was despondent over his imminent divorce, and using illegal painkillers.
It kind of describes half of America.
Seems like you've wasted your trip.
You've got a crew out there destroying every shred of evidence from a crime scene that's just about 2 days old.
He killed his dog, killed his two kids, then he killed himself. What more do you want?
I'd like to see the body.
I'd like to meet the Pope.
I could get a court order.
Yeah. Well, you're wasting my time.
You're misleading the public.
You're trying to get arrested.
I've got an eyewitness that says that the entry wound was to the left temple, not to the right.
Your eyewitness is mistaken.
Why would a small town cop change a murder to a suicide?
I'll give you to the count of three.
You must think you're on very firm ground, Sergeant.
One.
But I guarantee you.
Two.
You're not. It was no secret that back in 2012, Phil had been given some smoking gun information on the role Pinal Air Park had played in the 9/11 attacks. That information was to be the focus of Phil's third book on 9/11, information I suspected someone had been determined to prevent him from publishing. Now, to understand how Pinal Air Park relates to 9/11, a little background information is key. In the months before and after 9/11, Pinal Air Park was home to over 200 commercial aircraft, the highest number in decades. Airlines sent their aircraft to Pinal for quick maintenance. Others sent them there for long-term storage, and some were there for extensive overhaul. The facilities at Pinal are as extensive as some major Air Force bases, and sophisticated modifications are not unknown. As a commercial airline pilot with friends from his CIA days now working at Pinal, classified information from Pinal may have made its way into Marshall's hands, but it would take me several weeks before I would learn why such knowledge could turn deadly. The official story was everywhere. A local posting to members of the press said, if you are asked, you tell them that Phil Marshall was diagnosed as a mentally ill person who got his hands on a gun.
Good morning, students. We've come together today to wish two of our own a tragic farewell. Their young lives snuffed out by a mentally unstable and delusional parent, their own father, Marshall Phillips. A man everyone thought of as a loving parent to our own Chris and Megan Phillips, Marshall Phillips was apparently under a great deal of stress. Despondent over his impending divorce from Chris and Megan's mother, his whole life appeared in complete disarray. By coming together today, perhaps we can begin to bid Chris and Megan an appropriate farewell.
Hey, Sergeant. That blogger and some woman just pulled up.
Afternoon, folks. Ma'am?
I am Marshall Phillips' sister, and this is my house. Now, what are you doing in here?
Forensics.
Why? I thought this was a closed case.
Not entirely.
What then?
I'll show you. The neighbors all state they heard no gunfire. Also, it appears as though the two children were asleep on the couch when they were killed. So what we're trying to determine is how loud the gunshots were from outside the house, and whether or not the second child had time to react after the first was shot. Since you're here, you're welcome to observe.
No, go.
Are we ready?
Yes, sir.
I'll observe for the family.
Is the sound recordist ready?
Yes, sir.
Check the door.
Door secure?
This is the same type of weapon as owned by Mr. Phillips.
All right, here we go.
Time between shots.
2 seconds.
Coroner says both children had a blood alcohol content greater than 0.05%. So we can assume they were both sleeping soundly prior to the event. In 2 seconds, not enough time for the second child to react, much less defend himself.
Or herself. Which one was shot first?
No idea.
Oh. And were there powder burns on either hand of Mr. Phillips?
We'll have to look into that.
Oh, that'd be a good idea. You said also that there was a blood alcohol level of 0.05 or greater.
That's right.
Which was greater, the girl?
Yeah, it was 0.07 in her case.
So you ran a tox screen, a full panel.
I'll have to look into that.
And the fatal bullet, of course, you did a ballistics check and you found positively that the fatal shot came from Mr. Phillips' pistol.
You don't like the way I'm running this case?
No. I think you're doing a great job. You probably talked with the two agents that interviewed him on Thursday afternoon.
There were no agents here on Thursday.
No?
This is my investigation in my jurisdiction. You want to challenge my findings, you take it up with the DA.
Okay. Ballistics test, full toxicity panel, powder burns. Otherwise, I will. Sir, ma'am, have a good day. Barbara,
How loud were the gunshots?
Pretty damn loud.
Loud enough for the neighbors to hear.
Well, apparently, and I heard them.
Yeah, it's just that DeWitt's police report made it sound like all the houses were far apart, and that's...
Well, look at them.
Obviously not the case.
Good morning. You are Mr. Phillips' sister? And you are...
Yeah, a friend.
Of course. Such a tragic end.
May I see my brother, please?
Of course, of course. Please excuse me for just a moment. Here he is.
What is that?
Your brother's remains. He was cremated early this morning.
Just goes on and on.
I'm sorry?
Who gave you the authority to cremate the body?
The coroner, of course. The two children were cremated as well.
You asshole. Nobody called me.
I'm sorry, the coroner said they were finished with...
I don't care about no fucking coroner. What right does he have to decide?
The night of the murder, Marsh emailed me about receiving something he said was sensational.
I'm sorry. I don't want to think about it right now, Madison.
What if what he received was the proof that he needed to tie everything together?
I'm going to take Marshall home now, and then I'm going to move on. Thank you for being such a good friend.
Hey, that's all we want.
Excuse me for a minute.
You cremated the bodies without the family's consent?
Well, I have nothing to do with it.
Oh, really? Who did?
The county coroner.
So all of the tests that we discussed, nothing?
No.
They took 20 boxes filled with all of his personal papers, his computers. That's the kind of treatment that you give to terrorists and serial killers.
You know, you're really starting to annoy me, Mr. Freeman. You keep coming in here talking about conspiracy stuff, but you won't even look at the obvious.
Obvious? Well, I'll tell you what's obvious.
Phillips suffered from bipolar disorder. He was often heavily medicated, depressed, and mentally unstable. He was despondent over his upcoming divorce. He was deeply in debt. His doctor had him under orders to see a psychiatrist. This is why he lost his job as a pilot. There was simply no evidence of any intruders in that house.
Of course not. You had it all destroyed. Had the bodies carted away and cremated. And I'll tell you something else. He wasn't let go from the airlines because of some kind of psychiatric problem. He had a bad knee.
As the holes in the official story continued to widen, I tried to get several mainstream news organizations interested in the story. Predictably, there was only one.
Now that they like to kill the family now if they can. Is that to demonize the subject or be able to shut the whole scene down?
Yeah, it's to make the murder-suicide look plausible. That you've got a guy who's a ticking time bomb. Some of the local papers were terribly vicious against Marshall. The Union Democrat out of Sonora called him, you know, a killer.
It's a great way to demonize 9/11 truthers and, quote, conspiracy theorists.
Said he had some proof.
Clearly, someone is telling the truth and someone is making up fake news.
Well, when I found the Congressional Joint Inquiry report and learned that as soon as these guys hit the ground in Los Angeles on January 15th, you know, they were met by employees of the Saudi Aviation Authority.
Hey, Leo, thanks for coming by.
Yeah, what's up?
You knew Marsh Phillips, right?
He flew right seat with him for a few years before he moved up to captain.
And you made trainer.
Right. So?
I'm just curious about why the word of a commercial pilot isn't taken seriously when he tries to tell them about the amount of training it took for the 9/11 hijackers to do what they did. I mean, just, if you've just got a couple hours in a single-engine Cessna, you're not going to jump into the cockpit of a Boeing 767 and fly it right in.
Of course not.
So how come that's not part of the national conversation?
Well, Marshall tried to make it part of the conversation. Now he's dead. Then it might be why. Commercial pilots with thousands of hours have tried to duplicate the 9/11 attacks in simulators, and 99 times out of 100, they fail. Big passenger jets aren't built to fly at the speeds the terrorist pilots flew those jets. Push them close to 500 miles an hour, the wings start falling off.
Can I try it?
Simulator. The TSA doesn't let just anyone climb into the big simulators.
Did Marsh try it?
Of course. Yeah, we both did.
And he couldn't do it?
I'm telling you. Look, okay. Imagine you're behind the wheel of an 18-wheeler, okay? You think you could steer a big rig through a jiffy loop at 150 miles an hour without scratching the side?
I know, it's insane.
Yeah.
All right. But somebody flew those planes into the towers. And they had to get training somewhere.
Well, now you're on the right track. But don't waste your time looking at simulators. No, those pilots had to have training in the real thing, and don't let anyone tell you different.
As my research produced more and more that contradicted the official story, the folks controlling the official story seemed more and more desperate to run me out of town.
License and registration.
Why, Officer DeWitt? I'm assuming that there's a reason you pulled me over.
License and registration, please.
It's a rental, you know.
I still need to see the registration. You here on vacation, Mr. Freeman?
You know why I'm here.
You want to attract a lot of attention from law enforcement?
Is that what you pulled me over to tell me?
No. I pulled you over because you have a broken taillight.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. Fix it.
You spent the last 3 days looking into a murder-suicide which occurred in Murphy's late last week.
Oh, so you'd know all about this?
My understanding is that you disapprove of the way Sergeant DeWitt has handled the case.
Yes, and with good reason.
Is that right?
Yes, it was Officer DeWitt who pulled me over. So either Officer DeWitt is extremely incompetent, or he's involved in some effort to try to keep some facts from me.
Have a nice day, Mr. Freeman.
Clearly, this reporter had become persona non grata in Calaveras County. But at the same time, my assistant had unearthed some information that reached far beyond the small town of Murphy's.
There's only one company in the U.S. that trains Arab-speaking pilots in big jets.
It's called Doss Aviation, based in Colorado Springs.
They train pilots out of Pinal Air Park in Marana, Arizona.
According to Marshall, Muhammad Atta received at least part of his training from professional aviation witness in the village docks.
Also very interesting, Special Forces trains out of Pinal.
Yeah, well, that makes sense because Marsh said that he had a contact in Special Forces there and was sending him something.
A year after 9/11, one of the owners of DOS was appointed a federal judge.
Ho, ho, ho.
Marsha's getting too close, wasn't it?
Be careful, Madison.
Pinal, Pinal Air Park, the name kept turning up. Marsha had received something from someone in Pinal. And although I had no idea what it was, I had an idea who might.
How can I help you guys?
We need to talk to you.
About what?
About what you're after.
What do you mean, what I'm after?
The reason for your trip. We read your blog. Your friend Marshall Phillips, bragging about blowing the lid off 9/11 in his next book.
That have anything to do with the reason he was killed?
We're interested in what you think.
Your fans, huh? Excuse me.
Why are you here, Mr. Freeman?
This is a very public place, and unless you want some unwanted attention, I suggest you just back the hell off.
You talking to me, hon?
No, I'm talking to these two bozos behind me.
You're the only bozo I see.
Sorry.
So, what could we have done to reduce the chances that Chris and Megan Phillips would become victims of a psychopathic parent? What would have tipped us off? Well, we know that Marshall Phillips wrote controversial books filled with conspiracy theories about the 9/11 attacks. Did that raise any red flags for anyone? Now, the Phillips neighbors all say that Marshall Phillips seemed like a perfectly normal guy. Is a normal person addicted to prescription drugs? If your parents were taking prescription pain medication on a regular basis, wouldn't you be concerned?
He never acted weird or anything.
The FBI has instructed local police departments to treat anyone harboring conspiracy theories about the 9/11 attacks as a potential terrorist. What did Marshall Phillips do? He wrote books promoting conspiracy theories.
Wouldn't that raise a red flag for you? Tip you off that someone might just go off and start killing people?
Everybody liked Chris's dad. We all thought he was kind of cool.
So does anyone have any questions?
Hold it. When was the last time you saw Chris Phillips?
I don't know, the day before, on my way home.
You one of Chris's neighbors?
We're friends, yeah.
We're gonna stop by later and have a little chat with you.
Oh, cool.
I know. You don't think Mr. Phillips killed those kids, do you?
Hey!
I just thought you wanted to talk, but not in front of the cop. Now go. Just go! Come on, get!
Mr. Freeman's got a new friend.
Who's your friend, Freeman?
Was that whole show in there? Did you put him up to that? Or was that your program about the murder-suicide?
What, you think that kid's gonna help you find what you're looking for?
Oh, it's pretty obvious that I'm not the one looking for something.
Something like what?
You haven't found it yet. That's why you're still here.
Maybe hid it in a secret spot.
Oh, yeah. Along with the secret tape that got Barry Seal killed.
You were part of it.
Not even close.
You know, Marcia wouldn't speak to us either.
Big mistake.
We want what he's hiding. You understand me, motherfucker?
Yes?
Hello, I'm sorry to bother you. Earlier today, I met your son, and there was something that he wanted to tell me about Mr. Phillips.
Mike and that poor boy were in the same class together, but that's all there is to it. We don't want any trouble.
Yes, but ma'am, I don't...
Hey, mister!
You were at the cafe this afternoon.
Yeah, right, right. And those two guys, they're looking for you. I mean, they're here, right now, trying to find you. Son of a bitch.
I thought I was clear. Oh. You're not the same one.
Same one.
He said he wanted to talk with Mike, and you are?
Federal agents, ma'am.
We'd like to talk with Mike as well.
What in the world about?
About his friendship with Chris Phillips.
How do I know you're not the bad guys?
Well, the good guys, they want everybody to know the truth. And the bad guys, they want to keep it secret. That's what got Mr. Phillips killed.
What about Chris and Megan?
They're just collateral damage.
Collateral?
They probably wouldn't have been killed if they weren't at home.
Those fuckers!
When you spoke with Sergeant DeWitt, you weren't exactly truthful then, were you?
So what?
Well, I know you were at the house. I saw your tire tracks.
So what if I was?
You were the one with the flashlight.
Yeah.
What aren't you telling us?
Nothing. I left right after. What would you do, seeing your best friend like that?
And you only took 3 pictures?
Yeah.
Let me see your phone.
You didn't send them to anyone? Post them on Facebook or Twitter?
No way. What are you doing?
That's my phone. You send them to me, and then you trash them off your phone.
Somebody's sending that Madison Creek pictures.
Pictures of what?
Pictures of dead people.
Don't hang on to anything that they'd want. No, I mean it. No pictures, nothing.
Well, that's no fun.
You want to have fun, go to a skate park.
All right, look, they're tracking your phone. Now go. Get rid of it. Go, 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 go.
Oh, federal agents!
The hell is he going?
What's the matter? Kid on a bike too much for you guys?
Give me your phone.
Oh, what phone?
Where's... Hurry up.
Oh, yeah. Here we go. What you looking for?
He sent you pictures.
Pictures? Sent me pictures? I don't think he sent me pictures. He may have sent them to India or Bali. Bali. It's so...
Little prick, think he outrun us on a bike?
Goddamn kid!
Freeman's following us. Son of a bitch. This should be a law against guys like that. Where is he now?
Straight ahead, trust me.
Little fucker.
Right, he's gonna cross the road about a mile ahead of here.
Thank you.
Michael English, where is he?
He doesn't have anything to say to you.
Look!
No, you look. The night those two men came, Mike was in his room doing his homework.
And now two federal agents are in the hospital because your son attempted to destroy evidence.
Well, isn't that just too bad?
Ma'am, you're gonna force us to knock your door down. But we'll give you to the count of three. One.
Michael!
Two.
Michael!
Chris Phillips' friend Michael had been the first one to search the house after the murders. What he found was a photograph, the photograph that had been sent by Marcia's ex-CIA pal who had worked at Pinal for the past 20 years. The photo was of a Boeing 757 aircraft with the NASA logo on the engines and the tail. Now, if the photo was the reason Marcia had been killed, I needed to know much more, much more.
Cliff and Marsh had flown together when Marsh was a contract pilot for the CIA. He gave me some history on the photo and why it was important. What he told me was as upsetting as anything I'd ever heard. The plane in the photograph was a test aircraft, one of many civilian passenger jets tested by NASA and the FAA since the early 80s to develop remote control technology. The technology had been sold to the Pentagon by a man named Dove Zackheim, who worked for a company called Flight Termination Systems. Zackheim was prominent in U.S. military circles. He had authored a paper for the Project for a New American Century, which called for a massive U.S. military buildup. It was well known that the budget for such a buildup would take decades to be approved. Unless extreme circumstances, such as an attack on America he called a new Pearl Harbor, were to justify an immediate military response. 6 months before 9/11, Zackheim had been installed as the financial controller of the Pentagon. He worked closely with Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld and others, including Paul Wolfowitz.
The adversary is closer to home. It's the Pentagon bureaucracy. According to some estimates, we cannot track $2.3 trillion in transactions.
The following day, September 11th, American Airlines Flight 77 allegedly hit the Pentagon Square in the middle of Doug Zackheim's offices, killing 30 civilian auditors who had discovered the missing trillions and all the related evidence. Several U.S. Air Force doomsday aircraft were in the air on 9/11. One was spotted flying over Washington, D.C.
10 minutes ago, there was a white jet circling overhead. Now, you generally don't see planes in the area over the White House. That is restricted airspace. No reason to believe that this jet was there for any nefarious purposes, but the Secret Service was very concerned, pointing up at the jet in the sky.
Yet the possibility of the terrorist jets being flown as drones from these aircraft was never mentioned. Not by the press, not by the 9/11 Commission. The only reference to remote control of passenger jets was made a few days after the attacks by the president himself.
And we will look at all kinds of technologies to make sure that our airlines are safe, and for example, including technology to enable controllers to take over distressed aircraft and land it by remote control.
And the increase in defense spending followed soon after.
My 03 budget calls for more than $48 billion in new defense spending.
Is it any wonder Phil Marshall's threat to publish information linking Zackheim to the events of 9/11 might have turned Phil into a man marked for death?
Despite evidence that Saddam Hussein and Iraq had no connection to the 9/11 attacks, Saddam was nonetheless blamed, along with Osama bin Laden and Al-Qaeda. But Saddam had been targeted for regime change years before 9/11. A review of Yockheim's report, Rebuilding America's Defenses, reveals an obsession by its authors with total U.S. control of the sea, the air, and outer space, with an emphasis on bringing U.S.-style democracy to the Middle East.
The authors of the report included familiar names, William Crystal, Louis Libby, Paul Wolfowitz, and Dov Zakheim. Considering the political prominence of these men, is it any wonder that the post-9/11 intelligence community would control the official story, classifying top secret any information suggesting the U.S. government had planned and executed the 9/11 attacks?
Imagine the shitstorm that would ensue from revelations that the United States participated or even had direct control of events in 9/11. The destruction and controlled demolition of the Twin Towers, Building 7, 3,000 deaths of innocent civilians, and year after year of war after war, all justified by those attacks. But then, this all may be fake news, because as we told you at the beginning, only one of the stories that we presented here is true. So it is up to you. Did Philip Marshall, a mentally unstable man, depressed about his impending divorce, kill his two children, the family dog, and himself with his own gun? Or was Phil Marshall silenced to prevent him from revealing damning evidence that the terrorist attacks of 9/11 were the work of highly placed individuals like Dov Zakheim and others who were intent on world domination and control? I'm Madison Freeman, and this has been Fake News.
There has been a real problem in lost evidence, lost clues, and right now there's a demand for either the Attorney General of the state of California, Kamala Harris, to launch her own investigation of Marshall's death, or the U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder ordering the FBI in to conduct an independent investigation. That is the only thing that can be done now, although critical evidence has been lost, unfortunately.